We shall now go on to our next speaker, Dr. Jagannath Guramani, who practices at Surya Netralaya Vasi, New Mumbai. He's a vice chairman and ex-editor of the International Society of ISMICS, who has held very key positions in the various ophthalmic associations, has organized 3 world conferences of ISMICS, and has received many awards and accolades in his journey till today. Shall we go on to your presentation?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Chitra Madam, Namrata Madam. I thank the entire ARC and AIS. My video is with voice over. If you can't hear the voice, you please let me know.
Maybe you could talk, I think, no? Okay. We don't hear anything at all.
Okay. No, basically, yeah. If you're not careful, when you do the dissection, sometimes there can be scleral button honing. Now here the scleral button honing has taken place. So every time there is no need to change the site. Maybe you start a deeper dissection, go to the left side and form a new tunnel below the scleral button site. So you can have a proper tunnel again in the lower area. So this way you can proceed for a surgery in such complicated cases. Now here the repositories pass through the scleral button hole. So that is the upper tunnel, and I have formed a new tunnel. So that is a lower tunnel, which is a proper tunnel through which the entire surgery has been completed. Now in this case, I use the SA maintainer. Somehow there was a intraocular hemorrhage. The visibility was not very good. And I was trying very hard to pull the cortex from the region below the SA maintainer. Somehow it was not coming. And then suddenly I realized that I am pulling the capsule. So because of that, there is a capsular dialysis, zonular desensitization almost in 1/3 quarter. So I took a left-sided side port again and started doing the remaining part of the surgery. The point here to note is that now all the forces applied in the capsular bag is towards the area of the desensitization and not to apply any pull in that region. So even during the cortical aspiration, IOL implantation, for all the steps, the forces are applied towards the zonular insertion. Now, I'm putting the lens, intraocular lens, and as Lahane sir has pointed out, here I'm using the same lens itself as a CTR, because now lens will give the support to the capsular bag. Again, you see that lens is not rotated. The insertion also is towards the area of the zonular dialysis. Perhaps it is better to use a rigid lens for such cases. It will give a good support. Now, when I'm placing the other haptic also, I'm not doing any major rotational movement, but slowly I'm just pushing towards the dialysis area, and now I'm manipulating the upper haptic. So this way the major zonular dialysis managed without a CTR ring, and then you complete the remaining part. Now the cortical aspiration part also, I'm giving the support to the lens so that it is supporting the weak area, and then gently aspirate. The aspiration cannula is supporting the optic of the lens. And this is the final picture, almost a normal picture of this case. Now, I'll just highlight few of the uses of PC maintainer. Now, in this case, the PC has torn, but still there is no vitreous prolapse, and AC maintainer can act as a savior. It saves you because it maintains the pressure in the chamber, and you can complete the maneuvering, and with gentle maneuvers, you can complete the procedure. The bottle height also is lowered here, and there are no major jerky movements, and this lens is now implanted in the ciliary sulcus. So AC maintainer is now maintaining the atmosphere in the entry chamber. Here, the vitreous has prolapsed, so I have done the automated vitrectomy, but I have not stopped the AC maintainer. AC maintainer is acting as irrigation, but there is no turbulence because the bottle height is lower, and all the procedures manipulations are very gentle manipulations. So once you do the vitrectomy, you can gently do the aspiration without allowing further vitreous to come into the entry chamber. So with the AC maintainer, many times you can manipulate such cases in spite of a PC tear. And here again, a lens is implanted, a rigid lens in the ciliary sulcus. Yeah, that's all from my side. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Boramani. I have a little controversial thoughts about some of the things. So I'm going to ask you, I need the explanation for that. I mean, each of us know what is best, so I'm sure you will tell me. Now, I felt that it was not a buttonhole in that case. I felt that the incision should go along the contour of the globe, and maybe at that point it did not happen. So And then you, the next time when you went on a deeper plane, you went along the contour of the globe and you got a good incision.
Correct.
In that first case, I felt that you should have placed a three-piece IOL or at least, or even placed a CTR, because on the table, the pupil would look centered. But there could be an asymmetric back contracture later on. So the placing, because you said
Full limit, yeah.
3-4 block hours. That was one thought.
Correct.
And the second and the third case where you had a PCR, I'm not sure that lens looked like a single piece. If I'm going to place a lens on the sulcus, I would definitely place a three-piece only because of the angulation of these haptics from the optic.
Correct. So it's a rigid, it was a rigid lens.
Rigid lens, but it was, it didn't have the angulation, no, from the optic haptic.
Okay, okay. Yeah, yeah. Correct. Yeah, angulated lens is better. Angulated and three-piece lenses are better. Even for that first case of zonular dialysis, I said that the rigid lens would have been better because it keeps the capsule distended. It prevents the capsular contracture. Correct. Absolutely correct.
So, but your AC maintainer seems to have done a great job. You have any tips for the beginner surgeons about AC maintainer? Anything to add on that?
No, you have to practice AC maintainer. I have seen very few of us use AC maintainer. AC maintainer helps a lot, not only in SICS, but even in phacoemulsification. But somehow many surgeons are very skeptical about AC maintainer. They feel that it is a very dynamic surgery, very dynamic, and suddenly some complication can develop, but it's not so. People who are using AC maintainers and are used to AC maintainer, they get extremely habituated to AC maintainer. And in many cases, it acts as a savior. I think Dr. Lahani sir also will comment on this because he's regularly using AC.
Chitra, yes, Chitra, I use AC maintainer for all SICS. I do Blumenthal technique, but that is also one thing. Second, we all use the AC maintainer for the aspiration of the cortex after all phaco emulsifications, because here you'll have to change that by the bimanual and then the ETO and all other things. Now this comes in only 300 rupees. So each and every set has got the aspiration and AC maintainer. So that we aspirate, we have made a separate aspiration cannula. And I think the AC maintainer works wonder for the removal of the cortex, also for the SICS, also for the FECO. And when there is any problem inside that you are not getting rexis properly, lens is coming up, you can just put a AC maintainer and that helps you to deepen the anterior.
One comment with me.
Yes. Yes, Dr. Sudhir.
Yeah, ma'am. For the sulcus lenses, I feel one-piece PMMA lens is the best lens because it is like a hard lens. When you fix it, it's remain in the one place. It's not going to deform. And it's lighter also. So for the all my surgeries, I've done so many surgery of sulcus. So single-piece PMMA lens is 6.5 and 13.5 diameter is the good lens for my cases, all sulcus related.
Dr. Debashish Bhattacharya, are you there? He's not there.
Sudhir, Sudhir, what you said is it is a really best lens, not only for that, but I think for the anterior, this anterior chamber, you are the sulcus lenses. Yeah, the PMMA lenses are better.
One thing more, as sir suggested, I put this scler fixating lens produced by this RO11 6.5 13.5 with that hole in the haptic. So I don't use suture without it, and they do perfectly fine. And there is no uveitis. You can't recognize that thing. Yeah.
Dr. Debashish, do you believe in using AC maintainers for your SICS cases?
No, I'm not used to AC maintainers, but having seen surgeons using AC maintainers, it's a wonderful concept where you always have a tamponade on the surgical process, like if you have a PCR. So, you know, I mean, a phaco surgeon would inject viscoelastic, then take out the probe and do so many things. But this is automatically happening with the AC maintainer. So usually the anterior vitreous phase doesn't get disturbed. You may have a PCR, the PC rent won't enlarge, and you can perform the limited vitrectomy as Boramani showed. So all in all, there are so many advantages of an AC maintainer that we cannot really talk about. about using it with phaco emulsification when you are doing phaco emulsification, well, I would think that two fluidics may contradict. Like you have an irrigating fluidics which works on a particular system and rhythm, and you're adding another fluidics which is going by bottle height. I have my reservations, though I've never done either of them. But I do feel that, AC maintainers, the only thing that probably one needs is a very proper incision, an internal incision and an external incision, so that the nucleus engages properly and comes out, because that is a very pivotal thing. The entire process is quite passive, depending on the internal hydrostatic buildup of the AC maintainer that actually glides the nucleus over the sheets glide. So essentially, that's one thing that the new incisional construction and geometry has to be very good. That's it, where I think a lot of beginners struggle and they leave away the AC maintainer. And that is how they lose the benefit of this wonderful procedure. Yeah. They try a sandwich or a Vectis or some other guiding instrument for nucleus glide.